The renouncement, simply giving up something, is not a very good idea. You must have something better. Param dishtha nivartate. If you get something better, then you give up something inferior. Our Vaishnava philosophy, renouncement means renouncement of sense gratification. The Mayavad sannyas means karmatyag. Simply reading Vedanta philosophy, Sankhya philosophy, everything gimla. But our Vaishnava philosophy is giving up the wrong thing and accepting the right, side by side. Simply if I give up, it will not stay very long time. If I simply by sentiment give up, Brahma, Satya, Jagan, Mithya, this world is false, and Brahma is the reality. So there are so many sannyasis we see, they give up the so-called mithya world and come to the Brahma realization by meditation. By meditation, meditation, then meditation means hospital and school. Because there is no Brahma, there is no reality. So, after much meditation, comes to the conclusion that now I am a sannyasi, I must open school, college, and Daridranarayan Seva, and Gotnarayan killing. This kind of sannyas has no meaning. Daridranarayan Seva by killing Gotnarayan. Goat is not Narayan. Simply Daridras are Narayan. If you accept one as Narayan, why should you not accept the other as Narayan? So, this kind of false sannyas is not accepted by the Vaishnavas. Vaishnavas, they accept sannyas for better activities. For better activities means dedicated life for satisfying the Supreme Law. Mamekam saranam. Anyone who has sacrificed his life for Krishna, he is sannyasi. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Anasritam karma phalam karjam karma karoti ya. So sannyasi. Na niragni na chakriya. One who has given up. The sannyasi is not supposed to cook niragni. And non-niragni, non-yogi. But anasita karma phala. Tyag means karma phala tyag. This is tyag, real tyag. Suppose you are working, you are doing some business and getting lakhs of rupees profit. If you can give up that profit for Krishna, that is sannyasi. Otherwise, I shall enjoy fully the profit and I have become a great devotee. No. Sannyas means, as it is stated, anasritam karma phalam. Karma phalam, there must be some karma fall, whatever you do, there must be some result. Bad or good. So, anasritam, without taking shelter of the result of activities. Karjam karma karma. It is my duty. Just like Arjun did. Arjun understood that Krishna wanted the fight. He took it. Karjam. This I must do. This I must do. Krishna wants it. Because my business is to satisfy Krishna. I cannot become non-violent as I wanted to become. Falsely, Krishna, I don't want to fight with my cousin brothers, my nephews, my grandfather. That was my sense gratification. Krishna immediately said, oh, what kind of nonsense you are talking, that you won't fight? This is not good. Kutaste kasmalamidam visame samutne. What kind of nonsense you are speaking? You have come to fight in the battlefield and now you are talking that non-violence. So, don't talk all this nonsense because you are my friend, my cousin, brother. It does not look well. Anarjajistam, asargam akirtikaram. These things are done by the anarjas, not by gentlemen. Anarjajistam, akirtikaram. This will be infamous for you. Don't do like that. Then he explained to me Bhagavad Gita. And when he understood, then he took sannyas. What is that sannyas? Karishye vachanam tava. Yes, I'll fight. That's all. This is sannyas. Anasita karma phalam. He was first of all judging, if I kill my cousin brothers, my grandfather, there will be bad result. I'll go to hell. Now, later on decided, hell or him, I don't care for it. That is called anasthita. I don't take shelter of hell and him. I take shelter of Krishna. A devotee does not discriminate what is hell or what is him. Narayana parasarvi na kutaschana vibhati. One is Narayana Para, devotee. He doesn't care for what is hell or heaven. Sarga abhavarga narakeshapi tullartha darshan. A devotee, just like Narada, he goes to hell. He goes to heaven. He has got freedom to go everywhere. Tullartha darshan. For him, there is no hell, there is no heaven. He is preaching Krishna consciousness wherever he goes. That's all. He has nothing to do. Just like we went to that Sabarmati jail in Ahmedabad. We were received by the jail authorities where Gandhi was put into jail. Who was with me in that? You are also here. No. So we went to jail. They made very good arrangement. The prisoners, they received us. They chanted Hare Krishna mantra. It was a good function. So we went to jail, but what we have got to with the jail? We have no business with the jail. Similarly, sometimes we are invited in a rich man's house, governor's house. We go there, and that is heaven. So we have nothing to take either from this heaven or from that hell. We have to chant Hare Krishna mantra anyway. That is our business. So Narayana Parasatva na kutaschana vibhati sarga apavarga narakeshari tullartha darshana. So this renouncement for preaching Krishna consciousness, that is real sannyas. Just like when I went to your country, actually sometimes I had to live in a hell according to our Indian standard, Vedic standard. So what can be done? Hell or heaven, I have to do my duty. It doesn't matter. Actually, I do not want to describe those things. So, this sannyas means do not care for personal sense gratification. So, this is inconvenience, this is convenience. Simply go on preaching Krishna consciousness. So, This sannyas. Anasita karma phalam karjam karma karoti ja. Sa sannyasi is yogi. He is yogi, he is sannyas in everything. He is simply working for Krishna. There will be some result, loss or gain. So, if there is loss, that is Krishna's. If there is gain, that is also. Not that loss is Krishna's and gain is mine. No. Not like that. Everything Krishna's. We have to work for Krishna. To take this mantra. Come on. First, Bhavananda.
Dasamati Nandana Brajabada Nagara Gokula Ranjana Kana Dasamati Nandana Brajavada Nagara Gokula Sanjana Kana Dasamati Nandana Brajavada Nagara Gokula Ranjana Kana Gopi Parana Dhana Madana Manahara Kaliya Damana Vidhanam Gopi Parana Dhana Madana Manahara Kaliya Damana Vidhanam Dasamati Nandana Brajavada Nagara Nandana Kana Dasamati Nandana Brajavada Nagara Gopi Parana Dhana Ki Parana Dhana Madana Manahara Kaliya Damana Vidhana Dasamati Nandana Brajavada Nagara Mamaya Harinam Amya Vilasa Nabina Nagara Mara Manki Madana Subhasa Amara Harina Amya Vilasa Vikina Purandara Nabina Nagara Bara Manki Madana Subhasa Dasamati nandana bhajana bhajana palana asura kunana chana jana palana asur kilana sana nanda gadhana rakhala govinda madhava navanita dasana govinda madhava Navanita Tatsana Sundara Nanda Gopala Govinda Madhava Navanita Tatsana Govinda Madhava Navanita Tatsana Sundara Nanda Samati Nandana Braja Bhara Nagara Samati Nandana Braja Bhara Nagara Gokula Nandana Samati Nandana Braja Bhara Nagara Gokula Ranjana Ramana Tatachara
Everything that we see that is created by God. So you should at least recognize that it is God's property. But they are thinking their property. So there must be no restriction.
Is there a right and a wrong in this conflict now? Between the Arabs
thing is wrong
and Israel?
Because you do not recognize God. Suppose if you don't pay tax to the government, what will be the result? That is going to happen. This is the position of God, that He is everywhere. Annantarastham paramanuchayantarastham. He is within this universe. He is within the atom also. Annantarastham paramanuchayantarastham. Ekapasau rachayatam jagadanda koti jachakti rasti jagadanda chayajadantam annantarastham paramanu chayantarastham govindamadi purusham tamaham bhajami. This is Brahma Sanghita. The Lord, by expansion of one of His plenary portion, He is existing within this universe, not only within the universe, but within the atom also. Anoraniyaga mahato mahiya. This is God's qualification, that He can become the greater than the greatest. Just like the we have got conception, the greatest, this universe. We cannot even imagine how long, how far it is extended. But such universes are coming out from the breathing of Mahavishnu. Jakkaranavajali bhajatisma jugam nidravanantam saromakupam. From his breathing, when he exhales, innumerable universes come out, and when inhales, all those universes again enters. Bhutta bhutta praliyat. It is generated and again annihilated. This is going on. This is one side, that universes, innumerable universes, can be put into the nostril hole of the Mahavishnu. And another side, He can enter even within the atom. This is God, consciousness. Anoraniyaga mahato mahiya. He is greater than the greatest. We generally say God is great, but we do not know how great He is. People say God is great, but we have no conception how great He is. He is so great that He can swallow innumerable universes within His belly. Just like when Krishna was challenged by His mother, that show me your face. You say that you have not eaten the earth, your friends complain, and you say that you have not eaten, so I want to see, open your mouth. So when you open, He saw all the universes within mouth, all the universe. He proved, my dear mother, not only little earth, but the whole universe is within my mouth. So when mother Jasoda was astonished, she thought something illusory. All right, don't do it again. That's all. She does not know that here is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. To show me His mercy has become my child. She does not know. She always thinks, He's my child. She's under my control. This is the relationship of the Supreme Personality of Godhead with His devotee. This is wanted. Simply to understand God is very great, that is not sufficient knowledge. When you deal with the great, exchange your relationship with the great, that is perfection. That is perfection. Suppose your president is very great. That's all right. Everyone knows. President is very great. But what shall I derive out of that? When I actually deal with him, I become his friend, I become his servant, I become his secretary, I become somewhere or other. If I am related with that great personality, that is my benefit. Otherwise, what is the use knowing President Nixon is very, there are so many. What I am deriving from that gate, this is Krishna consciousness. The Mayavadi philosophers, they simply remain silent, God is very great. And they cannot imagine how great He is. But a devotee can understand how great He is. He can see that innumerable universes are within the mouth of God. This is the position of devotee. This is not sufficient knowledge. God is great. God must be great. That's all right. But unless you come in dealing with that great, you cannot relish actually what is God and how great He is. So here Kunti says, alaksam sarva-bhutana, all living entities, alaksam, you are invisible. Invisible, although antar-bahi-avasthitam, you are within and without. God is within yourself. Ishara sarva-bhutana riddhesho-arjuna-tishthati. Ishara, the Supreme Lord, is situated in everyone's heart. The yoga system means to see, find out that God, Paramatma, and meditate upon Him. Now the yoga system has come down as bodily exercise to keep the health very good, to reduce fat. This is yoga system. This is not yoga system. This is a bodily exercise. Real yoga is the God is within me, but He's invisible. Alaksham, antarbahi, although He is within and without, still I cannot see. So, meditation means concentrating the mind to find out God where He is within my heart. That is real perfection of yoga. So people do not know this science. Here it is nicely explained. Antarbahi-avasthitam, the Virat Rupa, just like Arjuna wanted to see the gigantic form of God. He showed him. So we can see the gigantic form in this universe. That is described in the Bhagavatam. You have read that the big, big mountains, hills, they are the bones of the gigantic form. They are described, the highest planetary system, Brahma Loka, is the